Hi friends, welcome back to Deanne's Paradise. Hope you all are doing good. Let me wish you all a happy Makar Sankranti and a happy Pongal. In this festival day, I'm sharing an extremely healthy and a tasty version of Sakkar Pongal. Traditionally, Sakkar Pongal is made out of raw rice and moong dal. So here I'm replacing the rice with millets. I'm using two types of millets here. So let's quickly check out the ingredients. 2 tablespoons of horsetail millet. 2 tablespoons of foxtail millet. 2 tablespoons of moong dal. 4 to 5 tablespoons of ghee. 1/4 cup of jaggery sugar, this is optional. 1/2 cup of jaggery. 1/2 cup of grated coconut, you can even use chopped coconut. 2 teaspoons of cardamom powder. 1 teaspoon of dry ginger powder. 10 to 12 cashews and raisins. First, take the millets and the moong dal into a bowl and wash them thoroughly 2 to 3 times and drain and keep them aside. I have washed and drained the excess water from the grains. Now add some water and soak this for about 10 to 15 minutes. Meanwhile, let's prepare the jaggery syrup. So I've taken a pan and added the jaggery and the jaggery sugar in the same pan and also add a few drops of water which will help the jaggery to melt faster. Keep the flame between medium to low. Else this will boil and come out of the pan, so we have to be very careful while doing this step. You can always make extra syrup and store in the fridge, but make sure you cool this down completely before you store. Now this looks almost ready. Let it cool down and we have to strain and remove any impurities from the jaggery. This is a very important step. Now put the soaked millet and the moong dal along with the water into a pressure cooker. Also add about 1/2 cup of water to it, because the size of the millet will increase 2 times of its actual size. So make sure you add enough water. Now add about 2 to 3 teaspoons of ghee and pressure cook this all for about 2 to 3 whistles. This is almost done. You can see the volume of the millets has increased and they have cooked perfectly. Now take another pan. I'm using a earthen pot just to give a little bit of traditional touch to the dish. To this add about 2 teaspoons of ghee. We have to roast the cashews and the raisins in this ghee. This is by far my favorite step to do, because the aroma that comes from the ghee is all over the kitchen and I just love the smell. Once they are ready, transfer the cooked millets into the same pan and give it a quick mix. Now add about 3/4 cup of jaggery syrup to this. This mix will absorb a lot of liquid, so make sure you add extra syrup to balance the texture. At the same time, you have to check the sweetness according to your preference. After combining everything, add the grated coconut to this. I'm using freshly grated coconut. You can even chop the coconuts and roast them while you roast the cashews and add to this mix. Combine everything and add a teaspoon of dry ginger powder, also about 1.5 teaspoons of cardamom powder and a pinch of salt to balance the flavor. Traditionally, we add a pinch of edible Casper as well to this, but because I did not have one handy at the moment, I skipped that step. This is ready. You can top it with some extra ghee and a pinch of cardamom powder, and you can serve it hot. Hope you all enjoyed the recipe. Do try this one and let me know your feedback in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon so that you won't miss any videos I post. So, till we meet next time with another exciting video, stay healthy and be happy.